this is fine. You see the disconnect here?
The Prophet does everything for reason.
Ah, there we go.
Ethiopia at that time was Christian.
It became Christian.
We know it
before,
was Christian.
Before the Western people even came, there was Christianity in Africa.
At the time, before Muhammad.
Right.
Before Muhammad. This is in the, like you said, 4th, 3rd century.
Yeah,
became
3rd century. Yeah, a majority so, Christian
so
country.
We know historically about... Yeah.
They claim it started earlier. You have Egypt, which Alexandria was Christian to start with, before it became a Muslim nation. Yes. Yes.
Totally. Was Alexandria was named after Alexander.
Yes. So, and then it became Christian. Then it became Islamic. Yes.
I'm not sure.
Yes. It was Christian. No. It was.
Alexander was
yes.
Alexander Christian.
Along with Syria.
Because you have Coptic Christians okay. in Egypt.
So,
right.
So, Ethiopia at that time was Christian.
It became Christian. So
we know it
before,
was Christian.
Before the Western so, people even came, before, there was Christianity in Africa.
At the time, before Muhammad.
Right.
Before Muhammad. This is in the, like you said, 4th, 3rd century.
Yeah.
Became
third
Christian.
Century. Yeah, a majority
so,
Christian
so
country.
We know historically about kings, Ethiopian kings,
right.
who are Christians.
Okay.
Okay. And who had interaction. And this is also documented.
Okay.
Interactions with Arabs.
Right.
Before.
Okay.
Before Islam.
Yeah.
Okay. And you're asking about historical artifact,
uh-huh.
telling you about a war.
Right.
And there are lots of things written.
Okay.
Like poetry.
Can you give me one of the poetry?
Yeah.
Okay, can you give me a name?
Give you. But let me finish.
All right.
About the war that happened.
Mm-hmm.
Basically,
mm-hmm.
His name was Abraha, Ethiopian.
Abraha. From the name Abraham, right?
No. His name was Abraham.
But what is the origin? Abraham.
Yeah, it's came.
That's
came
my point.
Abraham, yeah.
Because people so, name themselves after the historical
yeah.
people. When
but,
we look at pre-Islamic
then,
literature,
name,
no one was called Abraham.
So,
no one was
then,
called
but then if your name,
Isaac.
If your name,
no one knows anything.
Bro, if your name bro. Is Mike,
right?
I know damn well it came from Michael.
Yes.
Michael, the angel.
Right, exactly.
Yeah? But I'm not going to call you Michael.
Right.
Because you might be offended. Yeah?
Okay.
So your name is Mike.
Mm.
We know where it came from. Yeah?
Okay.
So his name was Abraham, full stop.
Yes.
So I'm not going into debate about
no,
that.
No, all I'm saying
so
is
I know his name came from that.
Yeah, all I'm but that's
let's not try to branch the argument.
Yeah, so all I'm just saying
everything
is
everything you find, you try to create another
no,
argument.
No, all I'm saying is that
so
is
let me finish and then respond.
Alright, no problem.
So Abraham
mm-hmm.
came and waged the war
right.
on Mecca.
Right.
This is before Muhammad.
Mm.
And I can go and give you, okay, history
mm-hmm.
or documented history about this.
Okay.
But then you were rejected. The same
why
as
are you saying that?
The other
you
thing.
See, this is how you're making your bad points.
No
you're
bad
saying,
point.
Oh, I will give you this
you
evidence,
rejected.
But you will reject
you
it. I'm saying, give me the evidence, and then I will accept it.
You're fine.
But your claim is, I will give you the evidence, but you're not going to reject it.
So why you rejected the other
it.
One?
Because they didn't give any evidence. They made
what
claims.
What evidence you want or you expect?
I said, give me the name of the source.
What?
That's it.
No, what?
Give me the name of the source. So you said,
the name of the source.
What was the name of the source?
You rejected that.
What was the name of the source?
Yeah.
What was it? You said they wrote, you said there's documents. Give me the name of the document.
So I gave you Smith Bible's Dictionary.
Yes, that's something,
yeah.
that's completely different. You just said now, the Battle of the Elephant. The Smith's Bible Dictionary does not talk about the Battle of the Elephant.
So,
so
I don't
I'm
see
saying,
the point. You want me to go and bring the name of the book.
You made brought up the Battle of the Elephant.
Yeah.
So I said, where's the evidence for it? You said there's plenty of evidence. Now you're saying, if you give me the evidence, I won't accept it. All I'm asking is for the evidence.
So at then,
Greek historians.
Any evidence, that's fine.
And then after that.
Give me the link and I'll look at
so
it myself.
So after that, you'll become Muslim? After
no,
that.
No,
they're bringing that evidence.
No, he couldn't.
You find another way to Islam.
Yeah. So this is the tactic. Yeah. You first say you've got lots of evidence.
Yeah.
Then you start saying I won't accept the evidence.
No, no.
Now you're saying I won't convert to Islam.
I have research.
Yeah.
It's Greek. Procopius. He mentions the war of the elephants.
Right.
He wants Arabic.
No, I didn't say Arabic.
He wants Arabic to document their history. Yeah.
Okay. Wait. Okay. Now, what happened at the history? I'm going to take what happened at the War of the Elephants.
You made a claim, you said give me something.
Yes.
I'm giving you something. Greek stories. Fair?
Yeah. So what happened at the War of the Elephant?
Well, I don't even know what happened.
Okay, what I'm asking
him,
because there will be some claims where some fantastical stuff happened.
What miracles of God?
I'm going
to
see.
You're telling me not to prove miracles of God.
No. I'm going to see if this story correlates to what he tells me. It doesn't even have to be
fair
a miracle.
Enough, bro. What you're asking for is proof of the battle. Give me proof of the battle. Now you're saying the details. I need proof of details. That's very...
Because I'm saying...
Do you understand where I'm coming from? Do you understand the point I'm making?
Yeah, and it's a valid point. So I'm saying, I want him to say what the battle is, and as long as there's overlap with that, then it's true. If he tells me something... For example, if this person says... Let me make it clear.
Look, there's the evidence, bro.
Right.
It says archaeological discoveries in Southern Arabia suggest the year of the elephant may be 569, 568, yeah?
Right. And wasn't that the year that your prophet was born?
Yes.
So was your prophet born in 589?
569 and 568, or 568.
Is that when he was born?
570.
So you believe it's 570?
Yeah, because it says,
okay.
According to Islamic history, that's what it was born in the year that it was. So that's when the Sassanian Empire overthrew the Aksumite affiliated rulers in Yemen around 570. And that's archaeological discoveries. It's not from Islamic history.
So you have, right. I have it's another archaeological another,
right.
Another
that's why I'll look into
another
that.
Reference.
Yes.
For you. If you are sincere.
Right.
To seek truth.
And
so there's one.
And the point.
Dr. Jawad Ali.
Right.
Al-Mufassil fi tariq al-Arab qabl al-Islam.
Okay.
He mentioned the story of, they even named the year, that year, of the year of the elephant.
Right.
In the Arabic history, they named it the year of the elephant. This is the year Muhammad was born.
Okay.
He was just born on that year.
Right. Okay.
Yeah.
So what does that prove?
Okay.
Because you brought it up. So are you saying that's a historical...
I'm just confused now.
Yeah, right.
Ask me about artifact.
Yeah. So I'm saying... So you're
saying the history of Arab was written before Islam, before Muhammad, yeah?
Yes.
So there is a book written documenting history before Islam.
Yes.
So the Arab history before Islam. Tariq al-Arab qabl al-Islam.
So you're saying...
Okay? Al-Mufassal, the detailed history of Arab before Islam. Okay?
Right.
And mentioning stories that happened in that time.
Right.
And one of these stories,
right.
the story of the war with Ethiopia, or the Ethiopian king or the ruler, who came from Yemen waging a war on Kaaba, and he was going to destroy the Kaaba, and it's all related to Kaaba.
Right.
Okay?
So,
before Islam.
But Kaaba didn't
come from nowhere.
Of course it existed before Islam.
The way you ask the question is like that.
The dispute is who built the Kaaba, and did any Arab
claim to your argument because you
brought up the name Ibra.
Yeah.
Now this would tell you that the Ethiopians were not Christian. Let me finish my point.
Abraha, in Arabic.
Right.
Yes.
Which is a it's from the name derivation.
Show me that
derivation of Abraham.
Show me that.
Yes. Abraham is Abraha, right?
No, show me that. Right. I don't know.
You don't know Abraham.
Musa comes from Moses.
Yeah, Musa and Moses are different.
Right.
Musa and Moses are different.
Yeah, but
the name Abraha is not Musa or Moses.
So what is Abraham in Arabic?
Ibrahim.
Ibrahim.
So what? Abraham.
But actually, no. But he was saying.
No, but you made a claim. I'm asking. Can you please provide the evidence, please, brother.
Of what?
Abraha
So it's not even necessarily. I have a translation of the name Abraham, not necessarily coming from Abraham.
Where does it come from?
Wait, one second.
Let's have a look. Okay.
One second, bro. It's a translation of the name Abraham.
Are you saying he's not? He wasn't Christian.
No.
In Ethiopian, in Ethiopian language, it means the one with the white face. So not necessarily meaning Ibrahim or coming from Maybe it's an Ethiopian name before Ibrahim.
I will look at the name. If I did make a mistake, it would be an assumption of mine because I thought Abraham. And that's what I'm saying. I can be honest in a discussion.
Even I don't know, but you made a claim, so therefore you have to provide the evidence.
No,
as simple as that.
Yes.
He made a mistake.
As you're asking us for evidence.
I'm not saying I know. I'm not saying I'm
the mistake. He made a mistake.
Yeah, made a mistake.
Right, so let's see.
Provide evidence, please.
He made a mistake.
Let's just have a look.
But what's the debate? What's it about?
So, what was it? Yeah, so my point was this.
The debate is Arab, they didn't come from Ismail. They came from Timonius. So the point he's making.
My wider point was.
Yeah, what's your wider point?
We have Islamic history that stems from the Prophet.
Okay.
Claims such as the Kaaba being built by Abraham, claims of Isaac and Hagar going to the Zamzam well and it being built, them running around the mountains.
Yes.
So my claim was, can we find any Arabs before Islam that affirm these stories themselves? If we can't find that evidence, my claim was it would be strange that a whole nation does not seem to know their own history until the advent of Prophet Muhammad. Because if I ask someone what is the source, they will go to Islamic sources. And I'm saying everything.
There was no one on that land. It was barren land.
But the Kaaba was there.
Look, slow down. But you just said right now that we claim the Kaaba was built by Abraham, correct?
Right.
So now you're saying to me, where's the proof of a Hajar who's running around?
Right.
This is the claim I'm making to you. The land was barren before.
So are you telling me between the time of Abraham, the Kaaba was there, and the time of your prophet, no Arabs knew or went to pilgrimage or do worship at the Kaaba?
Many.
Exactly.
No, they didn't.
Right.
The Kaaba was built by Abraham.
Right.
But it was because it was idols were worshipped around the Kaaba. The Kaaba was not pilgrimage. The Kaaba was because it was neglected. It was covered by sand. It was hardly even seen.
Until what century?
Was pilgrimage in
there was
Hanif,
there was
religion.
No, they didn't
the
know
the Kaaba.
Well, this is why I'm saying your host people are don't I seem to be confused about the history. So why should I believe in history? And I know you're not experts, but this is what I'm saying. Logic dictates there should be. Let me guess. Somali. Now, I can go to Somaliland and ask them about Somali history, irrespective of the Islamic influence. There will probably be some great kings, some warriors, or whatever that specific to your culture. So I'm saying, how can we do the same for Arabs? Because before the advent of Islam, they should have the same type of stories, songs, literature about Abraham or any of the stories in the Quran.
The people that came from Abraham be with him. Do you understand the point I'm telling you?
No, but I'm saying.
You're saying, if we claim the Arabs came from the son of Abraham, you're saying to me, but the Arabs need proof.
No, I'm saying.
The lineage comes
no,
from
I'm
there.
Saying, no, so no, listen to what I'm him. Saying. I'm saying, where did they make that claim themselves?
Yeah, where did the Arabs claim that they come from Abraham?
Yes.
They should claim that they are from Abraham.
Pre-Islam.
Okay, yeah.
Because it's a lineage.
Yeah, but that's what
Who
I'm saying.
Who has better lineage than Arabs?
Exactly, because that's what I'm saying. Arabs have their documentation.
I'll show you something about Arabs.
Exactly. So I'm saying,
which was he is saying who has better lineage than Arabs?
Exactly. So I'm saying, can we go to his? If I ask you what is the source of this information, you'll give me the Quran. You'll give me your prophet. That's not from the Arab themselves.
Can I ask you?
That's why I'm asking,
bro. Do you have historical? Hold on 1 second. One second. Because I don't understand the logic.
Okay. I'll make it clear because you're going to say something that I'm not a statement I'm not making.
Your grandfather,
right?
Your great grandfather,
yes.
Like the 1115,
right?
Do you have a historical artifact evidence that you came from him? Why are you not tracing your own history?
Because can I answer? So I'm not asking about specifics. So I would say for my tribe.
Yeah.
My tribe will claim. claim that they came from a certain place. So I'm saying, can you show me the Arabs before Islam make that same claim about their own history? So I'm not saying they need to prove it with hardcore evidence.
Wasting time.
What if your tribe was wrong?
They could be. My point is, did they make the claim?
You are careless not to trace your history.
I'm saying,
did the Arabs make the claim?
Exactly. So I'm saying,
I'm making an analogy.
No.
Why you don't have historical artifact?
Listen to what I'm saying.
Your great 15th grandfather.
Listen to what I'm saying. That's why I said you're not making the same argument I'm making.
Okay.
I'm saying, let's say we don't have documentation of my own lineage.
Yeah.
However, my ethnic tribe, I know if I go to the village, they will tell me the history of my ethnic tribe. Whether it's true or false is irrelevant. So I'm saying, because we're not saying because we can't prove it with hard evidence. But I'm saying they at least made the claim about themselves. So I'm saying, if Arabs believe that they came from Abraham, how come we don't have any Arabs mention that claim until after the Prophet Muhammad came?
What sort of evidence?
I'm saying that the Arabs made that claim themselves before Islam. So it could be poetry, it could be any of the inscriptions, it can be any sort of documentation, but at least evidence that they believe that themselves.
No, there is.
It's a moot point. So I'm, even if there is.
But here's the point. I'm saying, how is it logically we can go to any culture? He's from Somaliland. Everyone has some sort of. Somalia.
Modisha, Somalia.
Modisha, Somalia. So all I'm saying is, every culture has some sort of folklore. So I'm saying, how is it possible? Because remember, as Christians, we dispute the lineage of the Prophet. Because we have the Torah, which says a different lineage. So we disagree in terms of the lineage. Huh?
What does the Torah say?
Doesn't say Muhammad was from the Yemenites were possibly from the line of Isaac. But my wider point is this. We don't have any evidence from the Arabs.
Do you have evidence of Ishmael?
Yeah.
No.
You don't.
No. So that's not what I'm asking for. I'm saying, all I'm asking for is claim.
No, but I'm asking you.
Right.
Do you have evidence of Isaac and Ishmael?
No.
You don't.
No.
Who do you have evidence of? Only Isaac.
No, we don't have. We don't have any historical evidence.
So you're only accepting something before Islam.
Yes, I'm saying
What about the Arabs? What about the Arabs in the time of Islam? In the early time of Islam. So they are not, you're disputing the evidence because of Islam?
I'm saying, if you have
I give you a book now.
What do you want?
One second.
Listen to what I'm saying, very simply.
I can show you Wikipedia.
If I get,
you don't want to take that.
No,
I can show, I know what you're going to show me, but I'll show you. I've seen that Wikipedia article already about the, going back to
Canaan. So what if I give you,
Adnanites. Yeah, Adnan.
Adnan, yeah.
Going back to Adnan.
You're not
going to
take that.
Even within that thing, there's disputes about the origin. Look at the same article.
Just because there's disputes, doesn't mean that this claim is not here.
Right.
We're asking for the claim. Yeah, but we're saying to you the claim is there.
I'm saying the source. Yeah, but I'm saying the source of that claim is post-Islamic.
No, okay.
That's why I'm specific.
So you want pre-Islamic?
Yes, because if you look at the sources, I'm saying how can all the sources come from the 7th century? So we had thousands of years of Arabs, and we're saying we didn't have any history. But now, after the 7th century, we've got an abundance of their history. I'm saying I find that odd.
You don't find that, obviously, oral history, you can't, written history is not the
but
same.
You had the poets in Arabia, you had inscriptions, because even we know about the kings and their lineage from inscriptions in Arabia.
Yeah.
But the biggest things, we have no evidence of.
The
only evidence you have is trust Prophet Muhammad.
Okay, let me ask you a question.
Yeah. No, it's not that.
No. Let me ask you a question.
No. Right. He didn't
you believe in Noah?
So it's not.
Yeah.
Do you have historical evidence of Noah?
No.
So how can you believe in him?
Because
he believes
in
Noah and he doesn't have Noah.
You're missing the point.
No.
Remember, my argument was, is not whether he existed or we have empirical evidence. All I said was, is there a claim from the Arabs? So Jews will claim that Noah existed. I'm saying from pre-Arabia, do we have a claim from the Arabs affirming like the Zamzam well, the running between the because these are monumental parts of your faith. So with Abraham, with Noah, we don't have have the evidence, but the Jews claimed themselves that there was someone. Yeah, exactly. So I'm saying, that's what I'm saying. How come it's only in the 7th century we now have that information, but the Arabs themselves never made this claim?
But this is a claim that you, when you make it, it's like claiming Noah. You
yeah.
don't have evidence, but
exactly.
you believe it.
But that's what I'm saying. Yes, but that's what I'm saying. So I'm saying, I'm not asking for evidence.
I have a
All I'm saying is, for the Jews. No, but listen to what I'm saying.
For you in the second
wait, 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 wait.
I have an Arabic
yeah,
book
know,
for
wait,
you
let me,
in the second section.
I'll let you respond.
I have a book for you.
Yeah, wait, wait. Let me just respond to him.
Yeah.
I'm saying we don't have evidence for Noah. However, the Jews for centuries claimed that there was someone called Noah. So I'm saying we don't have to have evidence of the beginning or Abraham or these people. Do we have evidence of the Arabs believing this story to be true before the Quran? That's all I'm asking for. That's why it's the same criteria I'm using. So if you say, can I prove Noah? I'm saying, no, we can't. But at least there was the claim that people believe this to be true. The Quran claims this was a monumental part of your faith. So I'm saying, how come the Jews, the Arabs, seem to be oblivious to this?
So
if it was such a foundation to their faith. If I go to...
Your request, let me understand your request. So you're asking about a book that documents history, pre-Islamic history. It doesn't matter if it's like started post-Islamic, like if
no,
if
the writer, I want pre-Islamic.
If the writer is living in the time of
okay, if the writer
can be changed.
Are you telling me Arabs were changing their own history?
No. I want you to look in the Islam.
You
look,
see?
Look.
That's all. That's you're making my argument.
Let me say. Do you know
I want to.
In what way?
Just
way?
1 minute. Mm.
Do you know the Christian scholars agree that the Bible was tampered?
I'll respond to you.
Allah attribution. Allah in the Islam and Allah in the Christian.
Yes.
Compare between them.
Okay.
See the miracle in the Quran. Is there a miracle in the Quran?
Is there a miracle?
Yes. See, look at that.
Right.
If you look for the truth, you have to look the miracle. Where the miracle in the Quran?
Right.
What is the Allah attribution in the Islam?
Right.
Compared between, and so after that you.
But
you will.
But here's the problem.
You will get the right back.
But here's the problem.
But before Islam,
there is nothing to
believe it.
When you're ready to make your statement, but let me respond to that.
Yeah.
As a Christian, I believe people not from God can make miracles.
What?
I said, as a Christian, I believe people not from God can make miracles. Fortune tellers, black magic.
Who's from God? Who's not from God?
Fortune tellers, black magic. They can magicians. They can do things.
What is the difference between magicians and black magic?
They come from the same source, Shaitan.
Shaitan.
So he's saying.
So there is no black magic and white magic. It's all magic.
Yeah, black.
So white.
Yeah, but this is what people say to fool
Forget
people.
Forget about what people.
No, white magic is the same as black magic. It's Shaitan.
So it's magic.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But it's only people, other people, will say white magic like it's good and black magic, but all magic is bad.
That's trickery, not
exactly.
Not magic. Trickery is different than magic. Like
well,
sort of like.
What about fortune telling?
Skill.
What
game?
About psychics?
Fortune tellers.
Yeah, people who tell the future.
They look at the stars and they see like the...
So how come they know the future?
They don't know the future. They're
but
liars.
Some of them do.
They're liars.
No, but sometimes...
So probability science tells you that I can say something, it will rain today. And there is a chance to rain today.
No. Because
and if it rains, then they're right.
We know there's people who will say, I went to a fortune teller and they said something, wasn't the rain,
so they say
but more
vague
specific.
Things. They say vague things.
Well,
you're going to get sick in the near future.
Right.
I'm going to get the flu. Oh, I'm sick. Oh, they were telling the truth.
Mm.
It's all sorts of games like this. Yeah.
Okay. No, I don't believe that, but we can't prove it. So I won't dwell
or
on that
maybe
point.
Maybe they are magicians as well.
Yeah, but hold on. Even in the Quran, it tells you that the angels were taught they taught people magic?
No.
Yes, it does.
No.
Harut and Marut. What is the story of Harut and Marut? What does it say?
What does it say? Yeah, it speaks about two angels,
right,
who were there.
Yes. Okay,
and the people try to quote from them their knowledge,
right,
and then using part of the knowledge and do the magic.
So the people were able to do magic.
Yeah.
So it's real.
Yeah.
But you said it's not real.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. Bro. So people can do magic.
Bro, can I ask you a question?
People can do magic. Yes.
Do you know how old Zamzam water is?
You tell me.
It's over 5,000 years old.
According to who?
According to archaeology.
Okay.
Zamzam water has been there over 5,000 years.
Right.
Do you know accurate history? How far it goes back? Accurate history.
I don't know.
Less than 3,000.
Okay, now let's go with your point.
Wait. So
we're not even
Let me make the point.
We don't know.
Bro, let me make my point.
The claim is it was Egyptian.
Okay.
Listen to me. Listen. Let me make my point.
Who built it?
Let me make my point.
So where are you from?
Let me make my point.
One sec. What country are you from?
Sudan.
Okay.
Let me make the point. Yeah. So it's over 5,000 years old.
Right.
Accurate history, less than 3,000. Yeah.
Right.
So this is archaeology and historical evidence I'm giving you, yeah?
Yeah.
Not Islamic, yeah?
Right.
The word Zamzam, do you know where it comes from?
Where?
It comes from stop flowing.
Okay.
This is the command that Hajar gave the water.
Right.
So all of this, the name of it, goes to Hajar.
Right.
The origin of the water, the name of it, goes to Hajar.
There is
and also, over 5,000 years ago, this water has been there.
Right. Now you're telling me 5,000 years of Zamzam well and water.
Yeah.
Now, only in the 7th century do we find a story that tells you that Hagar was the one who said that. That's my argument.
Yeah, because
so in 5,000 years, you had to wait till the 7th century to find that out.
Because the 7th century, Prophet Muhammad came down.
Exactly.
And he was commanded by Egypt.
Right.
To say the story.
You've just made my point. So the Arabs themselves never said for 5,000 years, we have the Zamzam well. Yeah. By Hagar, but it had to wait until Muhammad came to tell them.
No, but where does the name come from? Stop flowing.
That's a claim.
Stop flowing. That's not a claim.
So okay.
The origin of the name.
Okay.
It means stop flowing.
Okay.
Zamzam.
Okay. To prove your point.
Stop flowing.
Okay.
It comes from the command.
All right. No problem. All you have to do now to smash this argument, show me one Arab that called it Zamzam. Show me a text before Islam. Wait. This is my claim.
Yeah.
Muhammad came, said this is the Zamzam well. Stop flowing. Listen to what I'm saying. This is my claim. Listen to my argument.
Yeah, but what is your source?
My argument should be very easy to refute.
What is your source?
Listen to what I'm saying.
No,
this is my claim that Muhammad came, called
it.
Let me finish my statement. My claim without evidence is Muhammad. Listen to what I'm saying. Muhammad called it Zamzam.
Is Jesus without evidence, not Son of God.
You see?
Yes, Muhammad
claimed it and everyone believed it.
Okay.
If you dispute it, can you show me a source where the Arabs called it Zamzam before Muhammad? That's all I'm asking for. Because then it would mean that his story is true and it will be the evidence that I'm looking
but
for.
What you said is a fallacy. Do you know why it's a fallacy?
Yeah.
Why? Because you said your claim is not real.
But listen to what I'm saying.
You
But you're saying...
It's a fallacy.
But listen, I can get rid of the Muhammad part. my statement still makes the same. Okay. Can you show me an Arab before Islam that called it Zamzam?
It's when been called Zamzam for 5,000 years.
Can you show me the evidence before Islam?
Yes.
Show me.
Because the well has been there for 5,000 years.
All you have to do, wait. All you have to do to prove your point is because there were maps of there were maps of the world before the 7th century.
Can I use all you have to do
is show me a 6th century map that has Zamzam written on it. That's all you do.
Can I use a
And
metaphor?
I believe you.
Can I use
it's
a metaphor?
It's not necessarily been on the map.
Why? Oh, yeah. So that's what I'm saying. Yeah. So everything seemed to disappear.
Bro, you're talking about...
No evidence.
No. Wait.
Yeah, maps. What was maps created?
Hang on a before second. The Romans used maps. We have maps from...
One second.
Romans.
Are you for real? Are you for real?
Yeah. When is the oldest do you map? Believe? No. Do you believe in Noah alayhi salam?
Noah.
Wait.
Yeah, believe.
Okay. Wait. No. About these.